Okay, my tank is back up to pressure. Again, I'll just shoot a little bit on here. Make sure nothing strange has happened. That's good. Should I be concerned that I had to leave this piece for, I don't know, 2 or 3 minutes while that happened? I don't think so. I don't think anything bad is going to happen. Just got to remember where you were at. I've just got to get this bottom shelf here. Sides of the shelves. Feels like I can turn this thing over. But I really prefer not to touch it if I don't have to. I can see some buildup on the front of this one shelf here. I'm going to wipe it off because it's just too much. Just going back to spray the fronts. That's better. And we'll clean it away. I don't think I put too much on there. Yeah, I don't think so. Oh, got some drips inside here. Don't want those. I think I'm spraying a bit heavier than I normally would. This could be tricky. Having to do this. I think I ran into some trouble there because I didn't flash off on my first pass down. I just went right through the shelving but built up a little bit too much. That's gonna be fine. So that's a coat on this one piece over here. Yeah, it looks pretty good. Now the whole point, what we're after here, is building up. We want to build up enough of this urethane that we can actually sand between coats, get the nice smooth finish we're after, but also protection. So I'm going to do the outside pieces here one more time again, just to get some build up going. I don't want to put too much on because I don't want it running down. Okay, that's the problem. It's got down. All right, just fire it up the bag. You starting to hear that I'm losing juice again. We'll probably need one more tank to get through this project. Yeah. Once it gets that petered out, I don't want to keep spraying on. So, as we did before, I'm going to go crank her up. I'm back. Now out on that compressor, I touched the tank and I started to notice it's starting to feel a little warm. It's not hot, but you know that's the third cycle it's had to run. Those tiny, I don't know how they make those oilless cylinders, but they must be like little pieces of aluminum or something just banging around in there with a lot of heat. And I'd be a little bit leery about, what I'm trying to say is I don't think you can do this continuously. Cycle that baby on, use the air, turn it on again. Because the heat will start to get your air too hot. Right now I think we're okay. We're probably bordering on where we would have a problem. Well, that dual action trigger makes it a lot easier to flash on too, you see, because I can just pull this much and all I get is air. It helps you set things up. And it's gotta hit the other sides of these shelves. Okay. Yeah, I'll give the outsides of these a second shot. I think I'm really done. You have to resist putting too much on. Because if it all just runs, you have a big problem. I'll get the camera and just take a closer look at this. As with our staining, what you see is what you get here. This urethane is a kind of a whitish color. And when it's built up thick, you'll be able to see white patches. Those are things you kind of need to be worried about. Because that means you maybe put on a little bit too much. There's a bit there, for instance. Can you see that? I know it's tough. My camera sucks too. Yeah. But what you're looking for here is just a nice, even, wet coat. It's nice when you're doing horizontal pieces to have the sun behind you so you can just look across them and hopefully see a nice smooth reflection coming back at you. Because these are standing up, I can't really do that. But it's looking pretty even to me. I'm gonna shoot it again. And this is just coat number one.